NeighborLink Chatham-Kent is a local Christian charity that serves Chatham-Kent residents in need of goods or services. Our motto is connecting people in need with people who can help. The support we provide comes in many forms, through volunteers who serve as drivers, friendly visitors, phone buddies, food deliverers, household organizers, and even small-scale renovators. But the most important thing we provide is human contact and friendship. 30 churches are involved. Each weekday morning at the NeighborLink office, volunteers receive calls from people requesting assistance. An account is set up for each person in need, and they're connected with organizations or volunteers who can help them. People like Harold Vanderandy, who on this day is picking up Roger at his home in Blenheim. Roger has medical appointments in Chatham, and Harold is providing transportation. Harold's role is vital, not just because he is providing a direct link to healthcare, but because he has developed a supportive relationship with Roger.
Roger and I actually have become friends. I've driven Roger a lot, and we had the opportunity to drive between Blenheim and Chatham. I get to know him, he gets to know me, and like I said, we're just good friends now.
In some cases, NeighborLink will provide transportation to medical appointments in Windsor or London, but the focus is mainly on Chatham-Kent. Roger says the support from NeighborLink keeps him healthy, not just physically, but emotionally as well. For that, he has a simple message for Harold and all the NeighborLink volunteers.
Thank you. Thank you for helping.
One of NeighborLink's goals is to help restore people's dignity by not only giving them material help, but also by helping them establish social connections. Loneliness is a real problem in society. For many people, their main social connection is their doctor or some other healthcare provider. Others even dial 911 just to have some human contact. Ken Powell is a retired pastor who now serves God through NeighborLink by providing transportation for people like Evelyn. Ken is Evelyn's link to her husband, who was recently admitted to hospice.
As I was approaching retirement, I wondered what I was going to do with the rest of my life. And I thought, you know what? You can only play so much golf. You only can go on vacation so much before it becomes boring. And I realized that there were a lot of people that had different needs. And God's given me good health, and so I wanted to help people in any way that I can. And NeighborLink, of course, offers a lot of services. We help people with food, shelter, transportation, and that's one of the things that I do, and so I enjoy doing that for NeighborLink.
Evelyn can't drive, and public transit isn't a realistic option for her. Evelyn says Ken Powell's ride helped her and her husband more than anyone knows.
Well, we've been together for quite a while, and to lose him now would be, it's going to be a hardship. And to go through NeighborLink and have the ride to go is helping me as well as it's helping him. Because when I go and see him, he just perks right up.
NeighborLink supports go far beyond transportation. The rising cost of rent and groceries is taking a toll on the community's most vulnerable. That's where Al Baker comes in. Al delivers food to families in need.
The number seems to be growing each and every day. You know, people just don't have enough money to get from month to month without reaching out for some sort of assistance because people can't afford to pay their rent and buy groceries. There's just not enough money in social assistance. So if you're on ODSP or the CPP disability or whatever, Ontario Works, things are tough. So we do what we can to make a difference and just to try and fill the gap.
On this trip, Al is delivering groceries to Robert and Gus.
I myself am on disability right now, and disability, I'm not partial to say, but disability doesn't go very, very far in today's community and society, and I'm not prideful, but I do reach out to the people that can help me out.
Back in the days when I was working, the red kettles and everything else, I had no problem dropping a $100 bill into one of them to help people that are in the need to where I am now. Same with donating food, same thing. But now I need the help. I can't do what I used to do.
NeighborLink's main food supplier is Chatham Outreach for Hunger. Other food suppliers include the Salvation Army and Praise Fellowship, one of NeighborLink's supporting churches.
By the time my rent and my utilities are paid, I live off of $429 a month, which isn't a lot. This is a great help, because without these guys, I would not make it through a month. I would have to starve for a week. So this is awesome.
NeighborLink's strength as a program lies in its flexibility. Just ask Alan, who lost his ability to work when he suddenly blacked out a few years ago, suffered an injury, and developed a combination of related health problems.
Between depression, my eye disease, I'm considered legally blind, and not being able to handle stress properly, I'm here alone pretty much all the time.
Today, Harold is helping Alan rebuild a life by helping him with some home renovations.
It's difficult for me to get out into the community to have I guess what you would consider normal friendships. Harold's been really good at just saying, hey, if you want somebody to talk to, give me a call. And we've done that a couple times for situations that I was being faced with that I didn't really know how to deal with.
The house repairs, truthfully, are probably the minor part of the need, although it's fun to work with Al. He's a very gifted person, able to do many different things. I'm amazed what he's done by himself already. But being able to do that with him has been also an encouragement for me, but undoubtedly something that just gives them the realization that although it's a large project, together we can do many things.
Jody Miller is the coordinator for NeighborLink's wraparound program, a program that wraps around an individual or family with a team of people to help them achieve goals and a better life.
One of the cool things wraparound does too is just connect with other local organizations. So that's been neat, just partnering with other organizations. So often we will refer people to another organization and then we support them as they're connecting with that organization.
Recover Together is an addiction counseling program that functions like a peer-to-peer group.
I started it, you know, from my standpoint, because of my experience in wraparound for 10 years, seeing people, as I said, that even after a year and a half, their lives were better, but they still needed better supports.
People dealing with addictions, any kind of addiction, meet each week to watch helpful videos and discuss their struggles in a group setting.
But it's for all addictions, so it can be for, you know, crystal meth or crack cocaine or fentanyl or shopping, cell phones, workaholism, middle class addictions. And we're all in the same level playing field. Nobody is better than anybody else. We all have things that we need to be set free from. In Christian terms, idols.
Steve Laurie is part of Street Friends, a group that joined NeighborLink in January 2023. Street Friends prepares weekly meals for the unsheltered and delivers them each Thursday.
Our tagline is that we're not delivering food, we're delivering hope.
They also do frequent community barbecues.
We provide food and meals to them, but it is not about providing food. Street Friends is about providing a friendship, so that if they ever decide on cleaning themselves up, you know, stopping the addiction, or just assistance with just life choices, we then have become a friend to them, someone that they can trust, someone that's non-judgmental, and so that they have in the past reached out to us.
The benefits and success of NeighborLink are obvious, but NeighborLink needs help.
Yeah, we need donations, we need drivers, we need volunteers. We need churches that would like to be involved in NeighborLink. We want to encourage anybody in the community that can help with small renovations, with drives, with visits, with phone calls, mostly just to encourage people to know that they're valued.
People are coming to us, they're struggling in life. They've, like growing up, haven't had good stable supports in their life, and they're at a point where they just are needing to make a change to get to a better spot in life. So they may be struggling with housing issues, they may be struggling with wanting to pursue a job, maybe just be able to communicate with other organizations or their family. Sometimes we have referrals from LINK, also known as CAS, just needing some extra support as they make changes in their life so that they're able to have their kids back at home with them. Just working with people, kind of mentoring them, empowering them by getting a team of people wrapped around them.
Encourage people, if you've got a few hours and you're wondering what you can do to help somebody maybe that's lonely, it may just be picking up a phone and being what we call a phone buddy, and just to check in with people to see how they're doing. That would be such a rewarding and a blessing. And of course, we do this to bring glory and honor to God, not to ourselves.
For those whose lives have been changed, they'll tell you NeighborLink didn't just provide a handout. The volunteers provided a hand up.
It is a help that's in our community that is greatly needed, and the services are there. So if anybody knows the telephone number, knows where that they can get in contact with Al and the services, it's a great thing to have.
Something I learned indirectly about NeighborLink is they meet you where you're at. It's not like it's a one size fits all. It's okay, this is where I'm at. This is where Al's at. The next person they help is at a different spot. They have different needs, but I didn't know that about them. I was quite surprised, to be honest with you, what they were willing to help out with.
I just hope they can keep on doing what they're doing, because without them, I don't know what I'm gonna be able to do. And that's it.
If you can help, or if you need more information, reach out at neighborlinkck.com. NeighborLink Chatham-Kent, connecting people in need with people who can help.